act in general upon their worldview, and their worldview rests upon what to them is the ultimate truth. Whether or not they are aware of it, the way a person looks at the world influences the way he sees things, the way he thinks, and his day-by-day behavior. This is what I call a worldview. What has produced the inhumanities we have been exploring in the previous episodes is the fact that Western society has adopted a worldview which says that reality, including people, is made up of matter, bits and pieces, things, nothing more. This is philosophic materialism, because in this view, only matter exists. Sometimes it is called naturalism, because it says no supernatural exists. This view is often labeled humanism, because it puts humanity alone at the center of things, not the Creator God. But whatever it's called, it is the underlying worldview of our society today. In this view, the universe did not get here because it was created by a supernatural God. In this view, the universe has existed forever in some form. Its present form just happened as a result of chance events. The materialistic, naturalistic, or humanistic worldview almost always has a very condescending attitude in regard to Christianity. Humanists argue that Christianity is unscientific and that it cannot be proved, that it belongs simply to the realms of faith.